So, Mr. Incredible, do you have a secret identity?
Every superhero has a secret identity. I don't know a single one who doesn't. Who wants the pressure of being super all the time?
Of course I have a secret identity. Can you see me in this at the supermarket? Come on. I just want to go shopping as Elastigirl, you know what I mean?
Super ladies, they're always trying to tell you their secret identity. Think it'll strengthen the relationship or something like that. I said, girl, I don't want to know about your mild-mannered alter ego or anything like that. I mean, you tell me you're a super, mega, ultra-lightning babe, that's all right with me. I'm good.
No matter how many times you save the world, it always manages to get back in jeopardy again. I mean, sometimes I just want it to stay saved, you know, for a little bit. I feel like the maid. I just cleaned up this mess. Can we keep it clean for 10 minutes?
Hey, get
the
back away. Don't get up.
Sometimes I think I just like the simple life, you know, relax a little and raise a family.
Settle down. Are you kidding? I'm at the top of my game. I'm right up there with the big dogs. Girls, come on. Leave the saving of the world to the men? I don't think so.
Deadly high-speed pursuit between police and armed gunmen is underway, traveling northbound on San Pablo Avenue.
Yeah, I've got time. Certainly, ma'am, but I suggest you stand clear. There could be trouble.
No, he's quite tame.
Here to help.
Attention all units. We have a tour bus robbery.
Tour bus robbery. I've still got time. Officers, ma'am, Squeaker.
Cool, ready for takeoff.
What the? Who are you supposed to be?
Well, I'm Incrediboy.
What? No, you're that kid from the fan club. Buddy.
My name is Incrediboy.
Look, I've been nice. I've stood for photos, signed every scrap of paper you pushed at me, but this...
No, you don't have to worry about training me. I know all your moves, your crime-fighting style, favorite catchphrases, everything. I'm your number one fan. Hey, wait!
You know... You can tell a lot about a woman by the contents of her purse, but maybe that's not what you had in mind.
Hey, look.
Elastigirl.
Mr. Incredible.
No, it's all right. I've got him.
Sure you got him. I just took him out for you.
Sure you took him out. His attention was on me.
A fact I exploited to do my job.
My job, you mean?
A simple thank you will suffice.
Thanks, but I don't need any help.
Whatever happened to ladies first?
Well, whatever happened to equal treatment?
Hey, look, wait. The lady got me first. Oh!
Well, we could share, you know.
I work alone.
Well, I think you need to be more flexible.
Are you
Doing anything later?
I have a previous engagement.
Now you just stay here. They usually pick up the garbage in an hour.
Hey, Frozo!
Shouldn't you be getting ready?
I still got time.
Well, with counseling, I think you'll come to forgive me. Wait a minute.
But you never say which part of yourself to be true to. Well, I finally figured out who I am. I am your ward. Incrediboy!
And now you have officially carried it too far, buddy.
Oh, this is because I don't have powers, isn't it? Well, not every superhero has powers, you know. You can be super without them. I invented these. I can fly. Can you fly?
Fly home, buddy. I work alone.
Oui, et t'as tenu complètement ridicule!
Can't you just give me one chance? I'll show you. I'll go get the police.
Buddy, oh, no!
It'll only take a second, really.
No, stop! There's a bomb!
Oh, hey! Let go, you're wrecking my flight pattern!
This one home and make sure his mom knows what he's been doing.
I can help you. You're making a mistake.
The injured jumper. You sent paramedics?
They've already picked him up.
The blast in that building was caused by Bomb Voyage, who I caught in the act of robbing the vault. Now, we might be able to nab him if we set up a perimeter.
You mean he got away?
Well, yeah. Skippy here made sure of that.
Incredible!
You're not affiliated with me.
Holy smokes, I'm late. Listen, I've got to be somewhere.
What about Bomb Voyage?
Any other night, I'd go after him myself, but I've really got to go.
But don't worry, we'll get him, eventually!
Hey, is the night still young?
You're very late.
How do I look? Good?
Oh, the mask. You still got the mask.
Showtime.
Robert Parr, will you have this woman to be your lawful wedded wife?
You're late. When you asked me if I was doing anything later, I didn't realize you'd actually forgotten. I thought it was playful banter.
It was playful banter.
Gotta get kind of close, don't you think?
You need to be more flexible.
I love you, but if we're gonna make this work, you gotta be more than Mr. Incredible. You know that, don't you?
As long as you both shall live.
I do.
I pronounce this couple husband and wife.
As long as we both shall live, no matter what happens.
Hey, come on. We're superheroes. What could happen?
In a stunning turn of events, a superhero is being sued for saving someone who apparently didn't want to be saved. The plaintiff, Oliver Sansweet, who was foiled in his attempted suicide by Mr. Incredible, has filed suit against the famed superhero in Superior Court.
Mr. Sansweet didn't ask to be saved. Mr. Sansweet didn't want to be saved. And the injury received from Mr. Incredible's actions, so-called, caused us in daily panic.
I saved your life.
You didn't save my life. You ruined my death. That's what this
is. Listen, my client has no further comment at this time.
5 days later, another suit was filed by the victims of the L-Train accident. Incredible's court losses cost the government millions. And open the floodgates for dozens of superhero lawsuits the world over.
It is time for their secret identity to become their only identity. Time for them to join us or go away.
Under tremendous public pressure and the crushing financial burden of an ever-mounting series of lawsuits, the government quietly initiated the Superhero Relocation Program. The supers would be granted amnesty from responsibility for past actions in exchange for the promise to never again resume hero work. Where are they now? They are living among us, average citizens, average heroes, quietly and anonymously continuing to make the world a better place.
Denied? You're denying my claim? Oh, I don't understand. I have full coverage.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Hoganson, but our liability is spelled out in paragraph 17.
I can't pay for this.
Bob,
I'm calling to celebrate a momentous occasion. We are now officially moved in.
Yeah, well, that's great, honey. And the last 3 years don't count because...
Because I finally unpacked the last box. Now it's official.
Why do we have so much junk?
Listen, honey, I've got a plan.
Say no more. Go save the world one policy at a time, honey. Oh, I gotta go pick up the kids from school. See you tonight.
Bye, honey. Excuse me. Where were we?
I want a fixed income. And if you can't help me, I don't know what I'll do.
All right, listen closely. I'd like to help you, but I can't. I'd like to tell you to take a copy of your policy to Norma Wilcox on Norma Wilcox, W-I-L-C-O-X, on the third floor, but I can't. I also do not advise you to fill out and file IWS-24754 form with our legal department on the second floor. I would not expect someone to get back to you quickly to resolve the matter. I'd like to help, but there's nothing I can do.
Oh, hey,
shh. I'm sorry, ma'am. I know you're upset.
Pretend to be upset.
Payment on the worker policy?
Someone broke into their house, Mr. Huff. Their policy clearly covers them against...
I don't want to know about their coverage, Bob. Don't tell me about their coverage. Tell me how you're keeping InsuraCare in the black. Tell me how that's possible with you writing checks to every Harry Hardluck and Sally Sobstory that gives you a phone call.